This is Parlour. We do everything for everybody in this lovely place. I've been doing fine dining for the last 20 years, and 5 or 6 years ago, I thought I'd come back to my roots and cook real food for real people in a real environment. The cow pie fits on the menu really well. There's more to it than it might have first seemed. You've got the green bone marrow and parsley and breadcrumbs exploding out of the middle of the pie, the beautiful golden suet crust, and the delicious stewed beef below. So the first job that we start with is making the beef stew. We get brisket, we brown it so it's nice and caramelized. We set that aside. In our caramelized pan, we put onions and mushrooms and caramelize them. We put the meat back on, and then we deglaze it with beer. So all that nice meaty goodness from the pan comes into the stew. And then we add a good beef stock, and we cook that with lots of chopped thyme, a bit of mustard, some salt, overnight. In the morning, we just check for the consistency of the sauce, see if it's thick enough. And then we set that aside. So that's the stew done. Then we make the suet pastry with butter and suet and self-raising flour and a bit of water. And we make a kind of lumpy stuffing to go back in. So we've got empty bone marrows, we've got the stuffing, we've got the pastry and the stew mix. And then we have to put it all together. So we put it all together. Now, some people claim it's not a pie, okay? Some people call it a stew with a lid on it, but I'm gonna call it a pie, okay? Now, Desperate Dan's cow pie is a stew with a lid on it, I think, but it's some pastry beneath. But I'm gonna go with it that there's just a lid on the top. So we get a little pie dish, we put the bone in the middle and fill it with stew around. We put our pastry over the top and we glaze it with an egg yolk and we set it in the fridge. When it's cold, we bake it in the oven to nearly done, and then we put the bone marrow in just to finish off at the last minute. And that's how you like it. You can have it with mashed potato, you can have it with cabbage, or you can just have meat and pie on its own. The top tip for succeeding with our Parlour cow pie is don't have a starter. Try not to have very much bread in the beginning, and try to finish the whole bloody pie because it's delicious. Now, we award 8 points out of 10 for finishing the pie and maybe the middle bit, but you only get 10 out of 10 if you chip all the pastry off the outside, okay? Because it's worth it and it's bloody lovely. So see if you can get 10 out of 10 instead of 8 out of 10, because I'd be disappointed.